Hello guys and welcome back to the channel. I hope you're doing great. This time I decided to share a paint with me video for you and I hope you enjoy it. In this video, I painted a horse portrait and I used one of my uncle's photos as a reference. After warm up and preparation, I started sketching in thumbnails and defined my composition. First, I sketched in vertical and then decided that I liked the horizontal mode better. I then toned my canvas and started drawing my composition on it. As my painting technique, I like to paint with layers. Drawing is the first stage in my oil painting process, so paying attention on my measurements is essential. Then comes the mapping stage. In this layer, I block the drawing with some basic colors just like a map. I start with the furthest thing away, which is the background, and then come forward to the foreground, and then the main subject. Also, in each section that I'm painting, I start with the darkest color and go lighter as I improve on it. I don't use my darkest dark or lightest lights just yet in this stage. These are just some basic tones that help me block the drawing and prepare the canvas for the next stages. I'm now going for the lighter colors and trying to fully fill the canvas. Doing this, we are done with the mapping layer. After the mapping layer has dried, now we are beginning the modeling layer. I usually start by the main subject, but before that I make sure to add a little background color to the edges of the subject to avoid sharp edges. Then I go and start on painting the main subject. It's essential to have a system when painting with oils. Otherwise, you will most likely get distracted and discouraged. Here, I'm first starting with the darks and go lighter as I progress. The main objective of the modeling stage is to find your values and create a three-dimensional subject on the surface. So having a system like that helps a lot. I'm using a combination of burnt umber and ultramarine blue to achieve the dark colors. And then add titanium white little by little to go lighter in the value. I adjust the color with my blue, red and yellow. Here I'm trying to get that 3D look by laying every step of the tones and values that I see. I also remind myself to consistently clear the edges of the painted areas to avoid sharpness. I went to paint from top for some reason. One thing to mention, the lighting on this portrait is super unusual, but I think I can manage to get the likeness. This color may look pure white, but it is far from it. I always mix my colors with something. I never use them straight from the tube. I tweak the tone or the value a little to get a natural color and match the reference as close as possible. For the shadows, I add more burnt umber or ultramarine blue to the mixture. I just want to take a moment here and thank you guys very much for all your support with the channel and the first video. I really appreciate you pulling the time to watch the video and sending me your beautiful feedbacks. especially my good friend Mark Jason, who is a great supporter, and everyone else who has subscribed to the channel, liked the video, and commented and shared. Thank you very much. So here I'm working on the neck of the horse. I'm not using any new brushes for this painting. I'm just using some cheap old brushes that I have in hand. I don't think it's necessary to get expensive brushes for oil painting. Sometimes the oldest brushes can make the best marks on a painting. I'm just laying on some hairs by adding light and dark colors and contrast with each other. I'm not painting every individual hair. It's just an illusion and it looks like that. And then I'm just filling in the rest of the horse by working with dark and going lighter and lighter. After the main subject is painted, I then go with the background. The same techniques apply here too, starting with the dark and continue to halftones and lights. The greens in the reference was too saturated. It's the downside to working from photo reference, especially the ones that are tweaked in Photoshop. I tried to tone down the greens a little, but still wanted a bit of saturation. I go darker in the lights as I go further away from the foreground. It is important to remember that things in the background don't go as dark as things in the foreground, so I'm trying to avoid high contrast in the background here. I'm also consistently clearing the edges to avoid sharpness, and then fill the rest of the painting with the same technique. Here I'm adding some small details to the background by adding some dark greens and working my way forward to the foreground again. And we are done with the modeling stage. Before we jump to the rendering stage, let's take a look at the palette I'm using. I'm using a limited palette of ultramarine blue, burnt umber, alizarin crimson, cadmium yellow, and titanium white. I use linseed oil as my medium, and here I saturate my values by applying it on the dried surface. I premixed my colors starting from the darkest by a combination of ultramarine blue and burnt umber, and then went lighter and lighter, adding titanium white to the mixture. I adjust the hue and color of the mixtures by adding yellow, red, and blue if needed. I'm still using those old brushes to apply details in the rendering stage. In this stage, it's just adding those extra details that needs to be added. In this stage, sometimes I use glazing and sometimes I reapply paint over the whole surface. It's important to consistently reload your brush when adding details. I'm just adding some marks in different directions to get a hair texture. This old dagger brush is helping a lot. It's all adding contrast, adding darks versus lights. That's the main trick with the hair. In the rendering stage, it's also important to rest easy. Give yourself time and enjoy the process. Don't rush into it. All the work we did in the drawing, mapping, and modeling stages, we did it to now enjoy the detailing process. Now I'm building in the surface of the painting one brush stroke at a time, defining dark hairs on the skin of the horse, and maybe some dirt. I'm making these marks to bring that quality of the texture and render it to a finish. The more time you give your painting in this stage, the more the quality improves. But you can overdo it very easily, so I'm being careful here. I'm taking a small amount of paint with my brush every time I'm loading it. It's almost like a dry brush. I'm not overloading the brush with paint. It's time to add those final brush strokes on the hair, the darker ones and the lighter ones. I'm working on some last marks on the lightest hair strands. A couple of final adjustments on the surface, with the horse and the background and the grass, and we're finally done with painting. It's time to call it and add a signature. Thank you very much for staying with me. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Watch my first video on the channel here if you haven't already. Thank you very much. See you on the next one.